हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई शुड वांट टू शेयर पेपर 3 अक्टूबर नंबर 19। इट कैरीज 75 मार्क्स एंड टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस पेपर इज 1 hour 45 minutes। नाउ आई शुड मूव टूवर्ड्स द क्वेश्चन नंबर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज रिलेटेड टू द इनक्वालिटीज। इनक्वालिटी इज बिहेविंग वेन वी सॉल्व द इनक्वालिटी वी शुड टेक स्क्वेयर ऑन बोथ साइड्स और वी शुड सिंप्लीफाई एक इनक्वालिटी बाय दिस मेथड बिकॉज इन मॉडुलस इट बिहेव्स लाइक अ स्क्वेयर रूट पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव वैल्यूज। 2 × 2x + 2 इज इक्वल टू टेक पॉजिटिव वैल्यू, 3x - 1 और 2 × 2x + 2 टेक नेगेटिव वैल्यू -3x + 1। Only take negative value on either side, 2 × x + 2 or 3 × x - 1 only take negative value on one side. So in this way I solve the equation and find the critical value x is equal to 5 and x is equal to -3/5. Hence we should apply these values to find our required region, inequality I mean. I first take a greater value of x greater than 5, that is 6. I applied 6, I put value 6 inequality and find that it's false. It means that area is less than x is equal to 5. And on the other side, I will apply the value lesser than -3/5, x is equal to -1. I found that it is also false. It means our area is between -3/5 and 5. So x is greater than -3/5 and less than 5. Question 2 is related to the remainder factor theorem in part 1. He is asking that 2x + 1 is a factor of p of x, polynomial of x. If 2x + 1 is a factor of polynomial of x, then the remainder of the polynomial should be 0. First I take value 2x + 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to -1/2. Put this value in the polynomial, p into -1/2 is equal to 6 × -1/2 cube plus a into -1/2 square plus b into -1/2 -2. I applied remainder equal to 0 because 2x + 1 is a factor of polynomial. When the one thing is a factor of polynomial, then remainder should be 0. In this way, we will simplify the find the equation a is equal to a minus 2, b is equal to 11. In second part, he is asking that x + 2 is a factor of polynomial in the case when remainder is equal to -24. It means when we applied x + 2 is equal to 0, x is equal to -2, we should take remainder is equal to -24 instead of 0. So p of x is equal to -6 × -2 cube plus a into -2 square plus b into -2 -2. We applied remainder -24 and hence find the final equation 4a - 2b is equal to 26. I solve these two equations simultaneously, I mean subtracting these two equations, a - 2b is equal to 11 and 4a - 2b is equal to 26. I found that a is equal to 5. Put this value in any equation, but I should apply here in equation number 1 and find b is equal to -3. Question 3 is related to the logarithmic function, also exponential function. 3 power 2x + 3 power -1 over 3 power 2x - 3 power -x is equal to 4. It's very difficult to solve this equation, I mean not possible to solve by simpler method. I take the value 3 power x is equal to y. I consider that 3 power x is equal to y, hence I replace 3 power 2x + 3 power -x, 3 power 2x - 3 power -x by y. First, 3 power 2x is equal to y square plus 3 power minus 6 is equal to 1 over y. Similarly, y square minus 1 over y. When I take LCM and solve this equation, I found that y cube is equal to 5/3. Now put this value, y taking cube root on both sides, I find the final value of y is equal to 1.1856. I put this value in equation number 1, 3 power x is equal to y. So 3 power x is equal to 1.1856. Take ln of both sides in order to take the value of x. When we take ln of x, the variable x should be in front of ln of 3. In this way, we will find the value of x is equal to 0.155. Question number 4 is related to the trigonometric part. I should strongly recommend you that first you should spend some time on the trigonometric identities. Then you should move toward this question. Otherwise, it will become very difficult for you. If you have a strong grip on your trigonometric identities, then it's very easy. You should only apply the नॉन ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज मूव टुवर्ड द फाइनल आंसर. इन दिस क्वेश्चन टेन थ्री एक्स इज इक्वल टू थ्री कॉट एक्स, आई रिप्लेस टेन थ्री एक्स बाई टेन टू एक्स प्लस वन एंड देन एक्सपेंड टेन टू एक्स प्लस वन बाई अप्लाइंग कंपाउंड एंगल आइडेंटिटीज. कंपाउंड एंगल आइडेंटिटी टेन टू एक्स प्लस एक्स इज इक्वल टू टेन टू एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स और वन माइनस टेन टू एक्स टेन एक्स इज इक्वल टू थ्री कॉट ऑफ एक्स. I should solve separately these two identities, tan 2x plus tan x over 1 minus tan 2x tan x, because it's very easy for me. If you want to solve these together, then should also apply. Otherwise, I will recommend you should solve these two separately, and in the end, you will place the values. So, tan 2x plus tan x is equal to, I apply double angle identity to tan 2x to tan x over 1 minus tan x square plus tan x as it is. I take LCM and I will get the final value tan 3 tan x minus tan cube x over 1 minus tan square. In the same way, I know I solve the denominator 1 minus tan 2x tan x here. Here I apply again double angle identity. 1 minus 2 tan x over 1 minus tan square x and take tan x as it is. Taking LCM and simplify this equation, I will find that 1 minus tan square x over 1 minus tan, so 1 minus 3 tan square x over 1 minus tan square. Hence, I write these two values in equation number 1. 1 mean tan 2x plus tan x over 1 minus tan 2x tan x is equal to 3 cot x. 3 tan x minus tan cube x over 1 minus tan square x over 1 minus 3 tan square x over 1 minus tan square x. The denominator 1 minus tan square is cancelled with each other. And I again apply the cot angle identity. Cot is equal to 1 over 10. So it will become 3 tan x minus tan cube x over 1 minus tan square x is equal to 3 over 10 x. In this way, I will simplify this equation by taking cross multiply each other. I will find the final quadratic equation tan 4x minus tan 12 tan square x plus 3, which is the required equation. In part 2, he is asking about to solve the this identity. The range of angle is from 0 to 90 degree. I have already extract the equation in quadratic form. Now I should apply the quadratic formula, which you have already familiar. Tan square x is equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac over 2a. In this way, I will find that tan square x is equal to 12 plus minus 11.5. Tan square x is equal to 12 plus 11.5 over 2, and tan square x is 12 minus 11.5 over 2. I simplify this and taking square root on both sides, tan x is equal to 3.43 and tan x is equal to 0.5. Only take positive values, not need to take negative values, because our angle is lies in the first quadrant whose range is 0 to 90 degree. And negative values move towards second quadrant, which is not required in this question. So I find the final values of x is equal to 73.7 degree or x is equal to 26.6 degree.